Give him a big hand. If you know tonight is your night, wave your hands and shout hallelujah. If you know tonight is that night that God will not pass by, wherever you are, wave your hand and shout hallelujah. Wherever you are, let's give the Lord a clap and a shout. Celebrate God. Celebrate God. This 21 days, celebrate God. Amen and amen. Wherever you are, before you sit down, I'd like you to look for 7 persons. Give them a high five if you can. Tell them you will hear my testimony after today. I'd like you to do that excitedly. I'd like you to do that joyfully. Prophesy your miracle. Prophesy your change. Prophesy your breakthrough. Wherever you are, you will hear my testimony. 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 If you believe that, let me hear that amen like a thunder. If you believe that, wave your hand and shout hallelujah. Amen and amen and amen. Give the Lord a big, 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 big hand as you take your beautiful step. Amen and amen. I feel very humbled by this opportunity to bring God's word back again. For as many of you that are very consistent members of Word of Life, you know by now, for me, this is home. By the privilege, you can clap, feel free to clap. By the privilege of my spiritual ancestry, this is home for me. I am the son of Dr. Joshua Talina, who is the son of Dr. Abel Damina, who is the son of our papa, AYOR Oritsejafor. And people of God, I want to say this without missing words. Papa is a gift to us, a national asset, a living phenomenon where the gospel is concerned. And I think my standing here today, I am a testament of his transgenerational impact. The fourth generation preacher from his loins. Ladies and gentlemen, we are blessed to have a papa. We are glad that he's still here for us to draw inspiration from. And we are glad that he's still impacting and touching the world. I don't know how many of you love him like we do. Wherever you are, please, let's appreciate my grandfather, the number one Christian in Nigeria, the preaching lion of the tribe of Africa. Please, let's celebrate my grandpapa, Papa AYOR Oritsejafor. You can do that. Celebrate this grace. Let's celebrate this anointing. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Papa, we love you, sir. We thank God for being a blessing. In Jesus' precious name, we thank you. One more time, let's celebrate my papa, my grandpapa, for his blessings around the world. Amen. In my 15 years of being a pastor, I have never been so busy like this year, just because I was part of the first Sunday in the year 2013. My life, my ministry, my finances has never been the same from the first Sunday until now. People of God, it's a great testimony. I must tell you the truth. Invitation is pouring for me all over the world just by the privilege of standing on this altar. I don't know where you are. Today, the 21st day of God arrives. Wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, they will hear your own testimony. They will hear your own testimony. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. Let me say this before we read the Bible. If you are a believer, you must know that with God, numbers are very important. Not all numbers, but there are certain numbers that before God, convey divinity. They create opportunity. Am I talking to somebody here? They deliver a platform. And I believe that reading through the Bible, for as long as there is a book called the Book of Numbers, numbers is important to God. Today, the 21st day of God arise, I prophesy to somebody, wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, you will feel the impact of your God. You will feel the impact of your God. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. Daniel chapter number 10, verse number 12. On the 21st day, ladies and gentlemen, the prayers of Daniel receive answers from the Lord. In spite of satanic delay, in spite of the principalities of Persia. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't care what has been delayed in your life. I don't care the powers that has constituted limitation. I am excited about this 21 day. By the end of this service, you will feel your answers in your hands. You will feel your answers in your birthday. You will feel your answers in your birthday. If your amen is louder, receive a testimony. If your amen is louder, receive a testimony. Say, I hear. Bring out your Bible. Let me run you briefly through the word of God. And I trust God tonight that by the combination of the grace that is available here and the supervisory unction of our Papa, somebody will not forget this 21 day. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. With God, there is no coincidence. With God, there is no accident. My coming today, by the privilege of being re-invited, is because God has spoken to Papa that I carry a word that will make the remaining 10 days the best day of your life. Am I talking to anybody here? We have 10 more days to go. I believe my coming today to initiate the remaining 10 days. I speak to somebody here. I don't care what you have waited for all your life. I don't care what you have waited for. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, and August. Beginning from the remaining 10 days, it will be the best day of your life. It will be the best day of your life. If you are the one I'm talking about, let me hear that amen like a believer. Slap your neighbor, say, I'm the one he's talking about. Carry your Bible with me and let's read it very briefly. Say, this is my Bible. Say it like you mean it. Say, this is my Bible. I believe it's the word of God. I am who it says I am. I can do what it says I can. And I must have what it says I will. If your amen is louder, you are the one that will have a testimony. I'm going to be reading one particular familiar story. But over the years, I've discovered that you can never be familiar with God's word. And as you give me your undivided attention, something is going to hit your spirit in a short while. I guarantee you this 21 day will go down in your diary. Who am I talking to here? This 21 day will go down in your diary. 1 Kings chapter number 18. For some of us that are students of the Bible, it's a very popular story. But I'd like you to know that God gave me a word for somebody here. And let's see how it goes. 1 Kings chapter number 18. I'll be reading from verse number 19. And I'd like you to follow me meticulously. If you're there, say amen. I think at this juncture, we need to appreciate our mama in absentia and believe God that our prayers today, wherever she is, will equally be part of our life. Please, wherever you are in absentia, let's appreciate mama with a big, 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 big clap and with a prayerful heart. Amen and amen. You better clap because she will come and watch the video. And if you are not clapping, give the Lord a big hand in absentia for our mama. Amen and amen. We thank God for her life. Hallelujah. 1 Kings chapter number 18. If you're there, I'm there. Chapter number 18. Reading from verse 19. I'm going to take it as quick as I can, lay a little emphasis where it is necessary, because it's a couple of verses I'm going to be reading. Are you there now? 19. Now therefore send and gather to me all Israel unto Mount Carmel, and the prophets of Baal 450, and the prophet of groves 400, which eat at Jezebel's table. And so Ahab sent all the children of Israel and gathered the prophets together on Mount Carmel. Are you there? Let's read verse 21. Everybody loud and clear. And Elijah came to all the people and said, how long will thou be in between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answer him not a word. Then Elijah said unto the people, I, even I alone, remain a prophet of the Lord. But Baal prophets are 450 men. Let them therefore give us two bullocks, and let them choose one bullock for themselves, and cut it in pieces, and lay it on the wood, and put no fire under. And I will thresh the other bullock, and lay it on wood, and put no fire under. Verse number 24. Everybody want to go. And call ye on the name of your God. And I will call on the name of the Lord. And the God that answered by fire, let him be God. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. Let me pause here to show to somebody. After today, your God will answer you by fire. For some of you, your God will answer you by money. For some of you, your God will answer you with that baby. For some of you, your God will answer you with that admission. For some of you, your God will answer you with that promotion. For some of you, your God will answer you with that healing. If your amen is louder, receive an answer now. Which verse are we? Are you following me? Which verse are we now? 20 what? 25. And Elijah said to the prophets, 25, are you sure? Alright. And Elijah said unto the prophets of Baal, choose you one bullock for yourselves, dress it first. You are many. Call on the name of your God, but put no fire under. And they took the bullock which was given them, they dressed it, and called on the name of Baal from morning until evening. Morning until noon, saying, Baal, hear us. But there was no voice, nor any that answered. And they leap on the altar which was made. And it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them. Please underline that word, mock. And Elijah mocked them and said, cry aloud, for he is God. Either he is talking, or he is pursuing, or he is in a journey, or peradventure he sleepeth and must be awake. And they cried aloud, cut themselves after the manner with knives and lancet, till blood gushed out upon them. And it came to pass, when midday was past, that they prophesied until the time of the evening sacrifice. Please, if your Bible is your own, underline that word, the time of the evening sacrifice. Please underline that word. That there was neither voice, nor answer, nor any that regarded. Verse number 30. Everybody, let's read. One to go. And Elijah said unto all the people, come near unto me. And all the people came near unto him. And he repaired the altar of the Lord that was broken down. And Elijah took 12 stones, according to the number of the tribe of the sons of Jacob, unto whom the word of the Lord came, saying, Israel shall be thy name. And with the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord. And he made a trench about the altar as great as would contain 2 measures of seed. And he put the wood in order and cut the bullock in pieces and laid it on the wood and said, fill 4 barrels with water. They poured it on the burnt sacrifice and on the wood. And he said, do it the second time. And they did it the second time. And he said, do it the third time. And they did it the third time. and the water ran around the altar, and he filled the trench with water. And it came to pass at the time, let's read verse 36. One to go, everybody. At the time of the evening sacrifice, that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am thy servant, and that I have done all this by thy word. Verse 37, everybody make it a prayer. One, two, go. Hear me, O Lord. Hear me, that these people might know that thou art the Lord, and that thou hast turned their heart back. Verse 38, everybody. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice, the wood, the stones, the dust, and lick up the water that was in the trench. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let's pray. Spirit of the living God, I stand on this altar today, the 21st day of this particular prophetic agenda. I pray like you answered Elijah. Let every man, every boy, every girl, every woman under the sound of my voice receive an answer tonight in the name of Jesus. And everybody shout amen. And everybody shout amen. And everybody shout amen. Please, I'd like you to listen to me very carefully, because everything I will be saying today will be highly prophetic, because my coming tonight is beyond human programming. It's by the special instruction that God gave to our Papa. And ladies and gentlemen, if you permit me to title this message, for some of you that are writing, it may be a title, but for some of us that are ready to pray, it's a prayer request. I want to preach on the topic I titled Commanding Answers. Say it again. Commanding Answers. Please say it again. Commanding Answers. If you know tonight is your night of answer, let me hear that amen like a believer. Child of God, I want to start by saying this. Does it not surprise you that one man whose name was Elijah put to death 450 prophets of Baal? My friend, against that number, Elijah wouldn't have stand a chance. Against that number, Elijah was outnumbered. Against that number physically, they would have lynched him. But ladies and gentlemen, by his abilities to command answers, only one man slaughtered 450 men. I have read through my Bible and I have discovered that if there is any prophet who knows how to command answer from God, I think personally is Elijah. As you read through the scripture, every time this man wants answers, it just suffices. One day he was relaxing on the mountain, and some overzealous soldiers came and ordered him down. As he looked at their arrogance, he declared, if I be a man of God, let fire come down from heaven. Ladies and gentlemen, in one swoop, a battalion of soldiers were swept and roasted, because Elijah understood how to command answers. In one of the occasions, he looked at the heavens, and without consulting with God, he said, from this day, there shall not be rain. And ladies and gentlemen, against the background of other farmers who probably must be sincere believers, one man suspended the atmosphere. My friend, Elijah was a man who knows how to command answers. And ladies and gentlemen, I discovered that by his abilities to command answers, everywhere he went, he was in charge. Everywhere he went, he was in control. I prophesy, after today, wherever you go, in your family, in your business, in your career, answers will be your portion. Answers will be your portion. Answers will be your portion. If you are the one I'm talking about, let me hear that amen like a believer. My friend, if you know how to command answers, you will pass through the fires of life and not be burnt. If you know how to command answers, you will pass through waters and not be overdrawn. If you know how to command answers, you will sleep in lion's den and make them pillows and massaging pillows. Because you see, I have come to discover that as a child of God, if you don't know how to command answers, you will be stranded in the battles of life. As a child of God, if you don't know how to command answers, you will be beaten down by occultic powers. You will be limited by enchantment, by divination, and by the sorceries of wicked men. That is why, if you are a believer, it's important to know how to command answers from your God. If I'm talking to you, let me hear that amen like a believer. Because you see, I say this with due respect. Some of you are like the prophet of Baal. You know how to pray, but you don't know how to get answers. The Bible speaking said, from morning until noon, they were jumping and praying. The prophets of Baal were shouting. The prophets of Baal were cutting themselves. The prophets of Baal were screaming themselves. The prophet of Baal, there was no jingoism that they didn't do. But the Bible concluded that they had no answer. There are believers in our time whose story is like the story of the prophets of Baal. They have shouted, they have jumped, they have fasted, they have cried, but they don't know how to command answers. And I believe that prayer should not just be for the fun of praying. It should be an opportunity for a mortal man to get answers from his God. I believe prayer should not just be a traditional, customary, religious exercise. It should be an opportunity for a man to open the ears of his God. It should be an opportunity for a man to open the hands of his God. I pray for you today, wherever you are, every prayer you have prayed that you have not seen answer, this 21 day, answer will enter your hands. Answer will enter your hands. Answer will enter your hands. If your amen is louder, you are the one I'm talking about. Lift up your right hand and say, oh God, answer me now. Say it again. Say, oh God, answer me now. If I'm talking to you, say, I hear. My friend, listen to me. If you don't know how to command answers, I say this without apology. Like Elijah killed 450 witches, we chop you like suya. If you don't know how to command answers, they will squeeze life out of you in that office. They will dash you hypertension. They will frustrate you out of life. That is why a lot of believers are frustrated, because you only answer the name as a Christian. But when it comes to getting answer from your God, you don't know how. It's not just about praying. My brother, you can pray like Anna all I care, but there is a particular way Anna prayed on a particular day. And ladies and gentlemen, that was the last time she asked for a child, because she prayed the prayer well. I pray for somebody here. I don't know what you have fasted about. I don't know what you have prayed about. I stand on this exalted altar. Wherever you are, answer will enter your hands today. Answer will enter your hands today. If you are the one, lift up that hand. Let me hear that amen. Are you aware that because they could not get answer, Elijah mocked them? How many of you have been mocked in your compound, in your family, because you don't know how to command answers? I will not forget, so many years ago, I think it was 5 years, one particular young man entered my church. When we were welcoming visitors, I was the one that welcomed visitors that day. And then I asked my protocol to lead them to a place where we attend to newcomers. And ladies and gentlemen, he wouldn't go. He held my leg. I said, what is it? They will attend to you. He said, sir, I came that your God will answer me. He said, we are a family of seven. I am the firstborn. My six brothers are stupendously rich. And I can tell the court that they belong to. Every time we return back to village, one is bringing his jeep, another is bringing his Cadillac, another is opening his house. But every time I come back to the village, I am hardly looking for what to eat. Sometimes I borrow money to come back, and they keep mocking me. Shebi, you say you are a Christian. Let your God give you money. Shebi, you say you are a Christian, or you prosper. Say, be you say you are a Christian or you are a biker. Look at us. We are occultic men and we are succeeding. He held my leg. He said he's not a newcomer. He wants a new testimony. Am I talking to somebody here? His testimony touched me because I saw a man that was mocked. That David said, how are they that trouble me who say there is no help in this God? I prophesy, after tonight, the God of this house will answer you. I am feeling the anointing. The God of this house will answer you. The God of this house will answer you. If your amen is louder, you will have a testimony. There and then, he was lucky that my shoe was his size. I removed my shoe and I said, wear it in exchange for your shoe and go out of this place. Ladies and gentlemen, the blessing of the Lord make it richer and added no sorrow. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to anybody here? Ladies and gentlemen, hear my testimony. I stay in Gombe State. When he left that service on Monday, he was staying in his empty shop. And that morning, one of the men that was giving the contract to build 2,000 housing estate in Gombe State drove past his shop and then reversed back to the man's shop. And he looked at the man sleeping. He said, I saw building materials in your shop and you hardly have zinc. You don't have nails. What are you actually selling? He said, sir, I am selling everything that's available for building. It's just that I don't have capital to put them in my shop. Whatever you see here is a sample. The man said, when I drop past here, something told me to help you. I am handling a contract of 2,000 housing estate in Gombe State. I will make you a supplier of all the building materials. Pakata parakata, rabagade bokota balata, rikapata. Am I talking to somebody here? My brother, by that encounter, a beggar became a multimillionaire. As I'm talking to you, in his father's compound, he has the best house. Among his brothers, he drives the best car. I stand on this altar. Wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, anybody that is mocking you, after these 21 days, they will see your answer. They will see your answer. There we see your answer. There we see your answer. There we see your answer. If you are the one, lift up your hand and shout fire. Shake your body and shout fire. Lift your leg and shout fire. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey. Help me slap your neighbor. Say no more mockery. Tell another. Say no more mockery. Say I hear. Kabarata, are you feeling what I'm feeling already? Are you feeling what I'm feeling already? This is the night of answer. I don't care how long you have waited for it. I don't care how long you have fasted for it. I don't care how long you have believed for it. But there comes a day that your morning is come to joy. When the Lord shall turn again the captivity of Zion, we shall be like them that dream, and our mouth shall be filled with laughter. The hidden will see, and they shall say, dear God, God have done great things for them. We are for, we are glad. Weeping my endure for a night. Joy comes in the morning time. I prophesy, wherever you are, receive your answers. 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 If you are the one, give the Lord a turn around. Amen. Hey, 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 say, I hear. Sit down, let me talk to you. Mahanda brakatesha ha, me edobu sapai. Child of God, it's important to understand that we serve a prayer answering God. Mahanda bushahai. It's important to get that at the back of your mind that we serve a prayer answering God. The Bible said, he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and he is a rewarder. There are many of you, because of your lack of answers, you are questioning the authenticity of your faith. You are questioning the ability of your God. Look at what the Bible said. Elijah said, how long will you be in between two opinions? I have discovered as a pastor that when as a child of God you can't command answers, you will always be looking for alternatives to your request. I say this, there are Christians who still visit native doctors in between two opinions because they can't get answers from their God. A member, an elder of a church in Gombe State, I wouldn't want to mention him, early in the morning traced my house and came. He said he has not been able to sleep for the past 11 days. I said, why? He said he would have loved to go to his own pastor and make this confession, but it would be embarrassing. So he decided to come to me. Because of the frustration in life, he traveled to a village in Niger where he was introduced to a mala, and he was giving sacrifices to do. His body was cut and some stuff inserted, and then they gave him some things to drink, some things to wear. By the time he came back, he told me for 11 days he has not been able to sleep. So he has decided to return it back. But he cannot travel to Niger. He wants me to burn it. And then let me pray for him so that he can repent. Are you aware? There are some of you, if we follow you home now, we'll be surprised to find some things. There are some of you, as much as you are a Christian, you are looking for alternatives. Because you don't know how to command answer from your God. Ladies and gentlemen, I have come to discover that all the names that God called himself, they are not nicknames. They are what he is capable, able, and available to do. He said, I am Jehovah Rapha. It's not a nickname. He is an answering God when it comes to provision. He said, I am Jehovah Jireh, I beg your pardon. He's an answering God when it comes to provision. He said, I am Rapha. He's an answering God when it comes to healing. There is no problem that God has not qualified himself with a name. There is no problem. Whatever your problem, God has a name that is the solution. That is why when you search the Bible, the names of God are numerous. Each one with his own ability, with his own capability and capacity to meet you at the point of your need. I prophesy today, the 21st day of this service, you will receive your answers. You will receive your answers. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Tell your neighbor, the names of God are not nicknames. They are solutions to your problems. I say this as we make an attempt to round up and then we pray. Those days that I was very small, talking about names and nicknames, I have preached for several years that this particular story has become popular comedy among comedians. We were in our father's house years back. I grew up in the barracks. And then my father's compound used to be a place where children come around to play because I used to be very playful. One of the days we were giving ourselves names, and one of my friends said, I am a lion. And all of us were clapping for him. Another one said, I am an elephant. All of us were clapping for him. Another one said, I'm a tiger. And all of us were clapping. It was my turn. I didn't know my father was watching. And then we had a little pet. It was a monkey. And I said, me? My name? I am a monkey. My father came and said, you are stupid. People are choosing good names. You are answering monkey. Change that name. Then I discovered my father was around. I said, okay. We used to rear pigs. And I felt, if I can't choose monkey, let me mention pig. I am a pig. My father slapped me. He said, I'll go back to monkey. The monkey is better than being a pig. Go back and answer monkey. Am I talking to somebody? Am I talking to anybody here? Your God does not answer nicknames. Whatever he called himself is what he can do. Whatever he called himself is what he can provide. Whatever he called himself is what he can defend. I stand here today. You will see answers tonight. Who am I talking to? You will see answers tonight. You will see answers tonight. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Lift up your right hand. Say, oh God, give me answers. Now. 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 me hear that amen like a thunder. Let me say this because I want you to pray today. Are you aware that as much as patience is a virtue, there are certain answers that processes must be circumvented? There are certain answers that must not follow procedure. There are certain answers you need it. You can't hear me. There are certain answers you need it. There are certain answers you need it. Imagine if Elijah had not gotten answer from God as of the time he got it, and he was standing between 450 people. You can just imagine. There are some of you, if this moon pass you by without an answer, your head may likely be in shame. There are some of you, if 2013 end and then you don't have that answer, I don't know how you will enter 2014. There are some of you in that office, if God does not answer you, my brother, you don't know where else to go. That is why today is an important service. I am telling you the truth. Wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, the God of this house will answer you now. 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 If your amen is louder, receive that answer. If your amen is louder, receive that answer. Say, I hear. Let me say this. I'm sure you are aware that the Bible is not a storybook. The Bible is full of the principles of God woven through the stories and the history and the biography of men. So that when you read the Bible, please, don't be carried away by just the testimonies. Don't be carried away by the personalities. Look for the principles that you can apply in your own personal life. So that whatever you are reading about can be duplicated in your own life. Because the beauty of the Bible is that the God who made it happen is the same yesterday. It's the same today. It's the same forever. Let me quote my grandfather. Somebody wave your hand and shout hallelujah. So, as I look at how Elijah gets his answers, I want to give you in a few minutes some very important clue that has changed my life. I wouldn't have been a pastor in the north if I had not known how to command answers. I would have been blessed today if I don't know how to command answers. Looking at the scripture, I saw very valuable principles that I believe will change your Christianity. So that you don't become like the prophet of Baal. Much noise, no answers. So that you don't become like the prophet of Baal. Full of activities without productivity. So that you don't become like the prophet of Baal. All day praying and nothing to show for it. Sweating and praying, and your reward is just a body odor without perfume. I want you to know from the word of God how to get your answers. I have proven it. It has worked. It's still working. The Bible said when Elijah came after they had prayed without answer, the Bible said, hear this, it's very important. He rebuilt the altar of the Lord. He rebuilt the altar. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that many of you have your impression about what an altar is. I believe an altar is a platform where a man personally fellowship with his God. I say this, it's very important. Many of you, you boast of your relationship with God, but with a broken fellowship. I want to say this. The altar was completely broken. Yet, they were the children of Abraham and the covenant tribe of Israel. I have discovered from God's word that the reason why many of you don't get answers is because you flaunt your relationship with God, but you are not aware that you are in a broken fellowship. As long as your fellowship with God is not intact, no matter the names you call yourself, I am a child of God. I am born again. We are talking about, can God reach you personally? We are talking about, when God talks, can you hear outside church? We are talking about, can you praise God even without an instrument? Because many of you are congregational fellowshippers, but individually you don't have a standing with God. And if you read the stories of Elijah, every time he wants to command answer, he said, before God whom I stand, before whom are you standing? Relationship can never be broken. God does not break relationship. Genesis to Revelation, you will always be his own. He will always be your own. But where there is no fellowship, you will pray. He will hear, but he will not answer. Where there is no personal fellowship, I believe that the church becomes a better place when people who have a relationship and a fellowship gather together. The pastor's job will be made very easy. Because many of you, you are a Christian, that you need to be followed up before you can actually worship God. And then on the day of your trouble, you are looking for answer. You only have a relationship without a fellowship. The father of the prodigal son, the son was still a son, but yet a prodigal. And for as long he was outside, he couldn't benefit from the father. He had to restore fellowship. He had to come to a point where he could feel his father, touch his father, hear his father, love his father. Fellowship is what command answers. Somebody say, I hear. There are many of you, as soon as we leave this church today, the hearing of God ceases, the fellowship of God ceases. You go back into strange lifestyle, that when you call on him in your most needed moment, your voice is the voice of a stranger, because you only have a relationship, you don't have a fellowship. Hear this. Fellowship makes you God's own. Hear this. I want to say it correctly. Relationship makes you God's own. And of course, everybody is God's own. But fellowship makes God your own. You own God in the place of fellowship. Am I talking to somebody here? You personalize God in the place of fellowship. You personalize God. You can say he is my God. I won't die by accident. You can say he's my God. I will get that contract. Before God whom I stand. Solomon said, for my God. As much as David was a servant of God, Solomon had a personal encounter with God that he could personalize God. Fellowship is one of the grounds where you can get answer from your God. So that by the time you come to church, whatever we say is a reminder, is an emphasis. Let me say this as I go to the second point. Are you aware that no matter what a pastor wants to do, where the work of God is concerned, there are certain instructions he cannot give you? You get it in the place of fellowship. If Abraham was a member, is there any pastor with enough boldness and audacity that can ask him to sacrifice his son? No, sir. No, pastor. There are many of you. God has told you very personal things to do for his kingdom, for the church. Yet, because you don't have a fellowship, your altar is broken. You don't have a personal feel of God. Somebody say amen. In 1999, I was living among Muslims because I had no money. And then actually, that night, because I was a very popular pastor, they planned to actually kill me. And then in the midnight, I was hearing serious noise. They were breaking my barrier gate, pulling off my windows. They came with knife, they came with dagger. And ladies and gentlemen, that was when I knew that there are times when you have to know God for yourself, for the prayer of your pastor to actually take effect. I prayed the prayer, Lord, will I die like this? When I shouted in my bedroom, the Lord said to me, stand still. Till today, still a mystery in Gombe State. They broke into my room, searched for me everywhere. I was standing in one spot. Jehovah blinded their eyes. Makabotakai. They overturned my bed. I was standing. They overturned my locker. I was standing. I wanted to be afraid. God said, I have spoken. Be here. Be still. They combed my house. They didn't see me. Out of annoyance, they left. And suddenly, I realized that an angel enveloped me. An angel covered me. My God gave me answers. Till today, it's still a mystery in Gombe State. I pray for somebody here, wherever you are, under the sound of my voice, Jehovah will give you answers. Jehovah will give you answers. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Don't brag about relationship. Build the altar of your fellowship. Know him for yourself. Know him. Number two, the Bible said, this point is very important, and I want to say it before you pray, so that you don't just shout. You must get answers. The Bible said when they had prayed, at the time of the evening sacrifice. Somebody say time. Talk to me, say time. Talk to me, say time. Now hear this. For many of you who are in the south, you may not know the implication of this statement. But for us who are in the north, we know what is timing. It is not about the time. On Fridays, for some of us who are in the north, particularly, I will not forget, one of the days I had enough money to shop in the supermarket, because in my family we shop for a month, because the north is very unpredictable. If you shop daily, an unpredictable situation may kill you with hunger. So it's better you shop for a month. In case there's riot, you have enough to be eating until the day clears. So we shop for a month, and I carry this money to go and shop. The man asked me, what and what do you want? Having mentioned it, it was a big money. And suddenly when I wanted to pay, he said, hold on. It's time for my prayer in the mosque. If you can wait, you wait for me. If you cannot wait, well, you can go. I need to pray, because at this time is my prayer time. People of God, let me make a very profound statement. You should know by now that every true son or papa is an audacity and is an authority when it comes to scriptures. I have discovered that if your value system for God is not in place, you will never get answers. It is not about time. It's about your value for God. Many of you, your value system is disorderly. Your value system is distorted. God has no value when it comes to you. God has no respect when it comes to you. Your value system is haphazard. Are you aware that the Bible said, except your righteousness exceed that of a Pharisee? The man left me with money, went to pray. From that day, I began to value God in another light. Hear this, and it's a very strong statement. God loves us equally, but treats us differently depending on our value for his person and his interest, which regulates our commitment to him and our investment. Hear me. It's very important that you understand God loves us equally. Everybody is equally loved. The love of God has no depth, has no height, has no breadth. Everybody is equally loved. But he treats us differently depending on our value for his person and his interest, which actually regulates our commitment and our investment in his kingdom. The value you have for God is what determines your commitment to God. The value you have for God is what determines your giving to God. The value you have for God is what determines your regular visit to God. Many of you, when God looks at you, he does not see value where his person is concerned. And let me say this, having been a preacher for some time, I have discovered in the realms of the spirit, you are weighed by your value for God. Lesser value, lighter weight. Heavy value, heavy weight. That is why many of you have not seen answers, because you don't have value for God. You will carry a phone of 100,000 in your hands. Your Sunday dressing, if we are to calculate it, is running to 500,000 from your shoe to your belt to your coat to your innerwear. And when they say it's offering time, when God makes sure your investment on yourself and the offering you are lifting up, he takes his eyes off your direction. Value. Value. Let me say this. Slap your neighbor. Say, are they here? Are they here? Are they here? Are they here? Word of life, are you hearing me? Let me make another pronouncement before you pray. Anytime you are in a contest with an unbeliever whose value for the object of his belief is higher than your own, you are at a disadvantage in that contest. Anytime you are fighting an unbeliever, you are pursuing the same object with an unbeliever whose value for what he believes in is higher than the value you have for your God, you are at a disadvantage. That is why every opportunity you have to place value on God, seize it. It will count on the day you need answer. When it's time for your tithe, place value on your tithing. When it's time for your prophet's offering, give, place value. When it's time for your church activity, to hell with any appointment, to hell with any commitment. You have a God who needs your time. In word of life, everything else will wait. Place value on your God, and on the day you need answer, he will answer you. On the day you need result, he will give you result. On the day you want his ears, he will give you his ears. If I'm communicating, wave your hand and shout hallelujah. The Bible said, when it was time for the sacrifice, he didn't want to hear their prayer. He stopped them. Hold on with your prayers. It is time for my own. I will not compromise my own. You have prayed from morning till noon. This is the time of my own evening sacrifice. I don't care what you feel. I don't care what you are doing. I need to place value on my own time. I won't mess with it. My God gives me credit and pass mark on this timing I need to keep. Many of you don't know that every temptation is an opportunity for God to score you. It's time for service. And you say, well, I went last time. I won't go today. Oh, you are scored. It's time for your tithe. You say, well, I have school fees to pay. I don't think God deserves my tithe. You are scored. Actually, hear this. The day you pray is not when God hears you. He calculates the value you have placed over him in time to determine your answer. That is why for every one of you here, this 31 days is a day of placing value each day. I may be tired, but it's about God and my destiny. I will drag myself. I may not have the money. It's about God and my destiny. I will drag to church. Hey, I may have some commitment, but this 31 days, I want to give God an unbroken fellowship. I want to give God an unbroken commitment. I want to give God an unbroken loyalty, so that when we enter the Ember Month, he can remember me. Well, when we enter the Ember Month, he can visit me. I pray for somebody here. These 21 days, under the sound of my voice, receive your answers. Receive your answers. Receive your answers. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. There are many of you here. Today, I think you need to repent. You know what I mean? You need to make up for the days you miss in God's eyes, so that the remaining 10 days, place value. So that the remaining 10 days, let God see a 10 days of an unbroken commitment. Let God see a 10 days of an unbroken loyalty. Let God see a 10 days of an unbroken commitment. And ladies and gentlemen, when God weighs your value, he is condemned to answering you. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Somebody say, I hear. Say value. Say value. Say value. In conclusion, before you pray, how to command answers. Build your fellowship. Place value on God. I will not forget, I say this. A man came and met me who is from a family of native doctors. The man is very rich. I'm on live television and one of the richest men in Gombe State. Suddenly, his children began to die one after the other. He had 6 children. The first one died. He thought it was a coincidence. The second one died. He thought it was an accident. The third one became sick. He said, no, it's not normal. He took the baby to all hospitals in Gombe State. There was no cure. And test was proving nothing wrong. The man ran to the village. Then the elders gathered and told him, The reason for the death of your children is because you have not placed value on the shrine of our forefathers. You are the firstborn, and by the tradition, your family keeps the shrine. And they pointed to one dilapidated shrine. They said, look at it. All of you have abandoned the altar. And your children will continue to die except you build a house, furnish it, put generator. Am I to somebody here? So that the gods will be happy. And when the chief priest come for the annual sacrifice, he can have a good room to sleep. The man, being a rich man, in a jiffy, he doesn't want the children to die. He built the house. Until I met him, I didn't know the value. He said, pastor, in less than 6 months, a house of about 7-8 million was standing. And the elders and the chief priest came, and they dedicated the house to the shrine and a room for the priest. When he came back to Gombe by the following day, his son slept and didn't wake up. The man became so pissed and very angry and depressed. After he had buried his son, he was so angry and went to the elders. I have spent money and my son still died. They said, actually, the God was so angry that the first offering was to cool him down. The second one should be the final appeasement. Am I talking to somebody here? That was when the man ran to church, because in church we collect lesser offerings and sacrifice. How many of you have built a house for God before in 9 million? We collect lesser sacrifice. So he ran to church, and they told him of Apostle Paul Odola, and he came to me. He said, sir, help me. My children are dying. In a couple of months and years, I have buried all of them. Remain just a few. Help me. And he told me his story. And being a very lenient pastor, I said, I'm going to pray for you. And by the integrity of the word I preach, if anybody dies in your house, I will stop preaching the Bible. The man was so impressed that I could make such a commitment. And I said to him, I said, think and look at your heart. Whatever you can give God of heaven as a sacrifice, I won't mention the amount. Just look at it and bring it tomorrow while you fast. I will stand on that sacrifice and close the mouth of the gods that is eating your children. I was very shocked. In fact, to impress the man, I told him I will fast with him. And that day I didn't eat, waiting for the man to bring his sacrifice. And I was ready to kill. And I was ready to deliver. Stood with my oil. The man appeared on my church altar. I said, lift up your sacrifice before God. When he lifted it, I peeped through the envelope. 5,000 was in his hands. I looked through the envelope. And I said, most often than not, some of you place value on devils when you are an unbeliever than you place on God when you come into church. As he lifted up his hands, I said, Mr. Chukwu, he said, yes. I said, if you don't live here now, I'll be the one to bury you, not the shrine. I will kill you in church like Ananias and Sapphira. And they'll go and bury you in the shrine where you have built a house. You built a 9 million house for a shrine. And I gave you the free will to value God. And you brought 5,000. I said, leave there before I kill you myself. Somebody shout hallelujah. For a girlfriend, you can build a house and buy a car. For the pleasure of meeting standard, you can buy a phone, Z10, and a shoe, Pakwakoni. But when it comes to placing value on God, you are looking for peanut. Now you know why you don't have answers. Now you know why you are stranded. Because your value system is disordered. Your value system is not in place. Hear me. Word of life. After today, wherever you go, you will see answer. Whatever you touch, you will see answer. Anywhere you enter, you will see answer. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. When I said that, the man got my point. And he went outside. I will never forget that day. Because you see, conscious of my time, many of you, if we give you a free will to value God, he will be embarrassed. If we allow you on your own to look at your heart and value God, he will be embarrassed. That is why sometimes we have to set a standard so that we can break your greediness, shatter your selfishness, break your egoism, so that out of yourself dying, a standard of God can be met, so that intervention can be guaranteed. That is why we create level. So that some of you will move out of your devaluation of God and wrong perception of divinity and meet the standard. Give your last salary and then you are bringing it. Sow a seed of the last in your account and you are bringing it. As scarce as the water was, Elijah said, pour it severally. Because actually, the sacrifice was not the animal. There were several animals. Water was the sacrifice because there have been drought for 3.5 years. So water was more scarce than animal. So when he built the altar, he said, bring water. Water is actually the sacrifice because water was scarce. When they brought water, he said, bring water again. They brought water, he said, bring water again. Don't be weary in well doing, for in due season, give and give and give and give until God commends your giving and then he becomes committed to your person. Break that limitation you set for yourself. And ladies and gentlemen, hear me and hear me well. When the altar and the fellowship were in place and the sacrifice of the water was in place, Elijah said, God, I need my answer now. Lord, I am tired of waiting. Lord, I am tired of begging. Lord, I am tired of borrowing. They have asked, where is my God? They have asked me, when will I be married? They have asked, when will I build my house? They have asked, when will I get settled? They have asked, when will I graduate? They have asked, when will I be healed? Hear me and hear me well. Word of life, wherever you are, today, the 21st day of God arise, receive your answer. Receive your answer. Receive your answer. Receive your answer. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Lift up your right hand. Say, oh God, answer me now. If your amen is louder, receive a testimony. Say, I hear. In an attempt to round up, you must know how to command answer. You need that answer now than ever before. My brother, this is the 7th and about the 8th month of the year. You need the answer, otherwise 4 months is just by the corner. You need that answer to reply your enemy. Are you aware that every time you have answer, it replies an enemy somewhere? Am I talking to somebody here? There are people who are waiting for when you will be a landlord, and in secret mockery they are waiting. There are people who are waiting for when you will get married. In secret mockery they are waiting. There are people who are waiting to see what you become in life. In secret mockery they are waiting. Hear me. I stand on the cycle of this altar by the blessing of my grandfather, Papa AYOR, Oritsejafor. Wherever you are, may God answer your enemies. 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 Let me hear that amen like a believer. Lift up your right hand, say, oh God, arise, answer me now. Let me hear that amen like a believer. Say, I hear. Tonight is the night of answers. That is what God said I should tell you. Night of what? Night of what? Anytime God arises, answers are guaranteed. Anytime God arises, intervention are guaranteed. Anytime God arises, supernatural help is guaranteed. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. Elijah said your God may be sleeping. Wake him. Your God may have traveled. Wake him. Your God may be resting. Wake him. May people not mock your God. You didn't hear me. May they not mock your God. After today, I prophesy, your God will close the chapter of mockery. That shame will come to an end in your life. That embarrassment will come to an end in your life. If your amen is louder, receive a testimony. If your amen is louder, receive your testimony. Let me hear that amen like a thunder. Lift up your right hand and say, oh God, answer me now. Let me hear that amen like a Christian. Jump on your feet wherever you are. Bakade bokosaha. Saboda kalita. Stand on your feet wherever you are. Meheda bakai. Ma anda bokosaha. Put your hands on your head. Something's about to happen. I'm telling you the truth. You say, Pastor, let me tell you my story. I have been waiting for it. Keep quiet. I'm not interested in your history. Answer is coming for you. I don't like your answer is coming for you. Answer is coming for you. Answer is coming for you. That man will see your good works. That man will see your good car. That man will see your good wife. That man will see your good husband. That man will see your good building and give glory to your Father that is in heaven. I prophesy to a woman, that will be your testimony. I prophesy to a man, that will be your testimony. I prophesy to a girl, that will be your testimony. If your amen is louder, receive the testimony.